Hello, this is Chris Bratt, and you're watching the Eurogamer Show, which usually has like two, maybe even three people on it, and goes live on a Saturday morning, but I'm a renegade and a rule breaker, so here we are instead. This week, I'd like to talk to you about my favourite game from Lionhead Studios. It's called Fable 2, and was released, bloody hell, almost 8 years ago now. The reason I've landed on this as the topic for this week's show is because, well, I'm sad to say that on Monday we discovered that Microsoft intends to close Lionhead, and in doing so, cease the development of Fable Legends. Now clearly things hadn't been going well behind the scenes there. Fable Legends had been delayed after originally being set to release at the end of last year, and frankly, I don't know that the interest had ever truly been there for a 4v1 multiplayer game, even within this universe. This universe, yeah, that isn't what it once was either. Fable Heroes, Fable The Journey, they never came close to capturing what made a real, numbered Fable game special, and we haven't seen one of those in almost 6 years now. And that's a shame. Looking back at the studio's history, it's hard not to resent the fact that their last properly new game that made it all the way to release day was a disappointing Kinect exclusive that had you waving your arms around in the air to cast fireballs. The name Lionhead Studios deserves a little more than that, I think. It's responsible for two incredibly influential series, and so I'd like to celebrate that for just a few minutes by telling you about one game in particular, which is, of course, Fable 2. Now, for me, it's not just the regional accents that make this game so very obviously British. More than that, it's the self-deprecating humour. You see, most fantasy RPGs tend to start with an impressive opening cinematic showing how vast the world you're about to explore really is, accompanied by a soundtrack that says, "Listen you, we got some Lord of the Rings level shit going on here, this is going to be epic." I mean, Fable 2 sort of does that. The cinematic follows a sparrow as it flies across Albion and approaches the great city of Bowerstone. It looks and sounds fantastic. The sparrow then proceeds to defecate on the head of our playable hero. And I've got a lot of time for that. It tells you right from the very beginning, the people in this world are gross and dirty and real. Even the savior of the world, the chosen one, isn't above getting covered in bird poo.
Oh, what was that? Oh, yuck.
Fable 2 does have its share of serious moments, so the story it tells is meant to, at times, make you feel angry and vengeful, but when it's not doing that, it also really wants to make you laugh. There's an immaturity to its sense of humour that I can't help but enjoy. You find it in almost every conversation you have outside of the main storyline, you'll find it in the item descriptions, the character designs, but you're also encouraged to take part in it yourself. Fable 2 knows that players sometimes like being a bit silly, where it's placing baskets on the heads of Skyrim shopkeepers or renaming your Pokemon to ensure that you subvert a perfectly innocent line of dialogue. Fable 2 is delighted by the prospect of you, the player, making fun of its world and the people that live there, including your own character. To begin with, your hero is known across Albion as Sparrow, thanks to the events of that opening cinematic, but you can earn different titles throughout the game, or instead pay the local town crier if you've got the gold for it. You may ask him to refer to you as Blade, Gunslinger, or Lionheart. Alternatively,
"From this day forth, this citizen shall be known to all as Knobhead."
And even if you don't pick a daft name, most of your interactions with the characters that populate Bowerstone and the surrounding towns and villages are ridiculous. Aside from the main characters, everyone that you run into, from the local blacksmith to the tavern drunks, has a very visible opinion of your hero, and that opinion can change as your renown grows, but you can also change it by actively interacting with them. Mechanically, this is actually a very, very boring system. If you'd like someone to fall in love with you, literally fall in love with you, all you need to do is repeat the same handful of gestures over and over again and ply them with a few gifts. It makes BioWare's relationships look positively complex. However, it does have the potential to look very, very funny. You're the hero of Albion, the one person that can stand up to the forces of evil and save the day, and there you are, in the town square, dancing and belching to win over the locals. It is ridiculous, and it completely undermines the idea that you're at the centre of some epic storyline, and I love it, because it makes me laugh. That, I think, is what makes this game and this series a bit special. Fable 2 is a fine RPG. It has an interesting combat system that has you switching between melee, ranged, and magic attacks on the fly. It has a beautiful world to fall into, full of things to do. You could spend an entire weekend easily mastering the various professions and purchasing property. You can have your hero act as a paragon of justice, defending the innocent from harm, or instead, you can usually just kill the innocent yourself and then buy the house on the cheap. You have a dog, and it is often the case in video games, that's important. But above all else, Fable 2 is a bit dirty and it makes me laugh. That's the difference. So thank you for that, Lionhead. The UK games industry wouldn't really be the same without you. Also, Black and White was smashing, I don't care what anyone says.
Knobhead!
Alright then, we'll be back tomorrow, as this video is going up on a Sunday. I hope you enjoyed a slightly different kind of episode this week. If you did, feel free to give the video a like, or argue about Peter Molyneux in the comments, whatever works for you. If this is your first time watching the Eurogamer show, I've included a link to the one that went up last week. It's Ether playing a scary demo using the HTC Vive, which is quite funny. And just a heads up, a couple of us will be going to the Game Developers Conference next week, so you can expect a bunch of video stuff coming out of that. I think I might be meeting John Carmack, which is pretty cool. I'll let you know how that goes. See you later.